My name is Zoya Bottesi, and I'm assistant professor in clinical psychology at the Department of General Psychology of University of Padova in Italy. Since 2013, my team and I have been interested in the assessment of skin-related quality of life, both in subclinical and clinical individuals. In particular, we have been focused in understanding if and how poor skin-related quality of life can be related with psychological distress in different populations. Our collaboration with the Clinical Genetics Unit of the University Hospital of Padova was established in order to gain further knowledge about the association between skin-related quality of life and psychological adjustment in individuals suffering from a neurocutaneous disease named neurofibromatosis type 1. A sample of 72 adult patients with neurofibromatosis type 1 who underwent a clinical follow-up evaluation at the Clinical Genetics Unit from 2014 to 2016 were asked to complete self-report questionnaires measuring skin-related quality of life, anxiety, depression, self-esteem and coping styles. Patients were grouped by means of a cluster analysis based on four dichotomous variables: sex, severity of the disease, number and distribution of cutaneous neurofibromas. We obtained two groups of patients. Participants of the first group had a larger number and a more widespread distribution of neurofibromas than those in the second one. Our study highlighted that patients with a larger number and widespread distribution of cutaneous neurofibromas have reduced skin-related quality of life than those with a lower number of cutaneous neurofibromas. This suggests that quality of life decreases when the magnitude of skin involvement is high. Moreover, we observed that skin-related quality of life, psychological distress, and coping strategies are strongly associated only in patients with a larger number and a more widespread distribution of cutaneous neurofibromas. In particular, in these individuals, the higher is the use of dysfunctional coping, for example, the use of avoidance strategies, the more impaired are skin-related quality of life, psychological distress, and self-esteem. In our opinion, our findings outline the importance of assessing skin-related quality of life in patients with neurofibromatosis type 1. In particular, current data tentatively suggest that patients with a severe skin involvement and who endorse dysfunctional beliefs about their own abilities about coping might benefit from psychological counseling and coping skills trainings, aiming to both improve perceived self-efficacy and to learn more adaptive coping strategies.